it be. What up, Roomie? I told you I got you.
Resolution Sports, the number one source, breaking from football up to extreme sports.
So come on and
join the resolution. Join the resolution.
So come on and
join the resolution.
Join the resolution.
Resolution Sports, the number one source, breaking from football up to extreme sports.
So come on and
join the resolution. Join the resolution.
So come on and
join the resolution. Join the resolution.
Basketball, soccer, MMA, boxing, any other sport you like.
We're checking in here at the New York Athletic Club, located by Central Park here in New York, New York, Manhattan. Came to stop by and catch a little bit of work with my man Fly Mike Marshall, who you all know, who is sitting on the right of the screen right now. But Mike, won't you go do everybody out there a favor, introduce this gentleman right here to your right.
This gentleman right here is Mr. Shawn Razor. He trained
Shawn Razor.
You know what I'm saying? He trained me in my first amateur fight.
That's why I call him Milk.
Yeah, you know I mean, my second amateur fight before I got with whoever and all that. He was the man. He the one that taught me everything I know as far as, you know, the basics and everything. So this guy's a great trainer. He trained Tor Hamer, a bunch of national champions, even a bunch of pro fighters.
Hide the stool.
Yeah. So
that ain't even right.
It's best not to do somebody else do it. You gotta joke with yourself. When one up Tor, always got love for your kid.
Yeah, man. So he's my head trainer right now. We getting things rolling, getting the ball rolling.
Yeah, that's why we up above this Olympic thing over here, because, you know, if we'd be successful, we might just take a round in the amateurs and try to make the Olympics. Well, first stop is we're going to try to do a simple tournament, New York local tournament, called a Pure Breed, which starts in September 5th and ends, I think, the 12th, right? September?
Yeah.
And then right after that, we're going to head towards the PL Nationals. We get to the PL Nationals, we're going to try to get rated within the top 10 in the United States. That's the goal for right now. If things work out well, we'll stay amateur. You know, especially if he's in the top three, top four, whatever in the United States, we'll start aiming to try to get to the Olympics. If not, Milk going pro.
Straight like no that.
Damn. Yeah, everybody been waiting on that.
Man, I'm ready to, you know, boy. They got a check. If they got a check with my name on it, I will bust
okay,
your
we all going pro.
Fuck the Olympics. No, hey, listen, man. It's real talk, man. And, you know, I've been through a lot as far as, you know, life in general. I'm sure, you know, everybody goes through life. So my story is not different. We all had trials
life
and tribulations.
Rough.
Yeah, no,
rough,
but listen, we all had trials and tribulations.
True.
But at the same time, you know, it doesn't stop me from putting in the work I gotta put in to be the person that I wanna be. You know what I'm saying?
So
at the end of the day, if I have to turn pro and bite a couple heads off, then that's what I'll do. But at the end of the day, I'm just trying to remain humble, you know, stay in the gym.
Trophies and gold medals are not going to pay bills.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying?
This is true.
A trophy is not going to buy a car.
Exactly.
Matter of fact, can you drive a trophy?
You can't drive no trophy.
You can drive a car, right?
You can drive a car. Right, and that car need gas.
Can you live in a trophy?
No, absolutely not.
You can spit in your trophy. You can drink out of it.
Exactly. You can't do
other people can spit in your trophy,
you
too.
Spit in your trophy, right?
Exactly.
And all you're going to really do at the end of the day is collect dust.
No doubt. And that's Shawn. Let's actually rewind a little bit, because the beautiful thing about this relationship here is, as Mike was saying, this is his original trainer. Now, let's go ahead and rewind it back. I don't even want to think about what this dude over here looked like when he came rolling in the gym for the first time. But let us know a little something about Mike back when he was just a young buck when he first put them gloves on.
Man, Mike was a little heavy. A little boisterous, you know, very boisterous as far as, like, believing in himself. You know, he's a little crybaby at the same time. You know, but as he matured, he certainly got out of that. You know, he's been pretty schooled. You know, as far as I'm concerned, when we fought in the gloves, he did real well. Got a couple of write-ups. You know, I think we got to the quarters or something like that. He did really good in his novice year. And he fought 165. So I got him down, you know, and from then on, he made a little move and he continued his amateur career. But it's close to 40 amateur fights, and I'm real proud of the kid.
And now Mike talks a little bit, too, about, you know, hooking back up with Shawn here, getting you back sharp as a razor yourself. But, you know, anyone who's watching this video sees there's a lot of work that gets put in here. There's a lot of emphasis on a lot of different things to not only craft this game of boxing, but also to get yourself fit, get yourself strong. Kind of talk about the workout that you get out here.
Well, I try to let me speak. I try to get these guys to work on agility, mobility, and some power. So you figure if you're agile and you're mobile, that leads to being hostile, baby. Once you hostile, that means you believe in your ability.
Somebody write that quote
you
down, please.
You can just about do almost anything, man, in boxing. You know what I mean? You can be able to slip. You can be able to roll. You can be able to bring some power punches. That's why, if you saw in the workout, I had to mix it up. Power shots, speed shots, punches and bunches, and movement. You know what I'm saying? So you figure all that. The only thing I didn't do a lot of was defense. Right. You know, that's what pros are basically at. But right now, these guys are amateurs. So,
right.
Or I just gave them like an amateur workout.
Right.
But basically, that's what it is. It's all about agility, you know, and mobility.
No doubt. Mike, give me your take on the workout.
Well, people forget that.
Didn't you get your time, Mike?
Huh?
Did I get your time, Mike?
No. People forget that. Shawn's a real trainer, and what I mean by that, he's a real trainer. Like he fits your style. You understand what I'm saying? And also, he had amateur fights before. You know, he knocked out some coaches when he was an amateur. So it's not like he's just a guy that just came, walked in the box and said, boxing gym, wore a couple mitts, you know, met up some people and said, I'm a trainer now. You know, he's the real deal. You know what I'm saying? So at the end of the day, I trust.
No Knox.
Right.
New York Sports Club.
Exactly. You know, I trust everything.
The school of hard knocks.
He took Tornheimer, and made him a national champion and a successful pro. You know what I'm saying? Until Tor did what he did. That's his thing. But it's not because of Shawn. It's not because of Shawn's training. Shawn's training is immaculate. You know what I'm saying? I only want the best around me. You feel what I'm saying? We got Duchesne Crooks, who's 6-1, a great professional. You know, he came up just like me. You know, at the time, I don't know if you know.
Here comes the bus.
No, but I don't know if you know. But when we was in the gloves in 2009 mm-hmm. or 2008, whatever, I was 78. Duchesne was 78.
They fought I believe in Marcus Brown, Olympia.
Yeah, he fought 78.
So well, he's down to 54 now. So.
He's down to 54 now. So Duchesne fought guys 200 plus in the amateurs. Now he's fighting guys 154. He's knocking everybody out.
Yeah, we call him Lil Tyson. I call him AKK. Here comes the bus. Man. He's throwing the punches.
You know what I'm saying? So
he's a nice little guy, man. He's
I mean, I'm around
skills.
Good guys. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Like I don't
and
have
very
to
worry positive about, young man.
Right.
Very spiritual too.
And I don't have to worry about the nonsense, especially with other fighters. I come up here.
Sometimes you need that. Yeah, you just need mm-hmm. that where you can focus and you ain't got to worry about all the drama.
You know what I'm saying?
You know, you get that in a lot of gym, even with coaches. I get that. You know.
Right.
But being that I'm up in this gym, I call this lab work.
This is the laboratory.
You come here and we work on lab stuff. You know,
Shawn's an
pack.
Evil genius.
Simon Bar Sinister. Or the Brainiac. Yeah. But anyway, then I take the guys to the other gyms, and then we practice what we practice here on these guys. Mm. You know, whether it's Mendez, whether it's Gleason's, whether it's Jerome's gym, whether it's Church Street, we go down there and, you know, it's wrecking food time.
Do what you gotta do.
Yes.
And now, Shawn, what are some of the components in Mike's game that, you know, obviously you've seen from the ground level up? You know, what do you say are, you know, some of the great tools that Mike has within himself that, you know, one day, ultimately, when he does turn pro, he's going to be able to make that transition and
he
transition well.
He believes in himself.
Right.
Mike believes in himself. Milk don't play, bro. You know, he's pretty focused. He's seasoned now as far as amateurs. Okay, when you fight a guy like Ron Newman 3-4 times, Max, these guys are pro material. When you fight guys like that, that only market, whether you win or lose, that only markets you more and makes you that much more experienced. You know, so you figure with the experience, with his background, you know, with the fact that he's focused, the fact that he believes in himself, basically now it's just tightening up on his defense, trying to work on certain techniques, and as you saw in some of his workouts, I have a conditioning coach now to strengthen him up. Once Mike is strengthened up, I think it's over. It's basically what he needs. Just got to get a little stronger, you know, and I think it's over. He can be able to handle a lot of guys.
Absolutely.
At the top-notch level.
Absolutely. Now, Mike, when you hear that, you know, from Shawn, who saw you when you first stepped into the gym, you hear those words coming out of his mouth, you know, how proud does that make you to know how far you've come?
It makes me real proud, and I'm definitely looking forward for things to come. I'm just excited. Like every day I wake up, I'm just ready to come to the gym. I find myself some nights staying up late because I want to come to the gym the next day. Like that's how I feel about
that's
it.
That's anxiety.
You know what I'm saying? Like, but like it's like I saw this movie, 30 Minutes or Less. I don't know if you're familiar with it, but it's a movie called 30 Minutes or Less. If you got it, just look it up. And it's about a pizza delivery boy who gets caught up with some bad guys. And then, you know, and the bad guys strap a bomb to his chest and said, if you don't rob a bank within 10 hours, the bomb is going to blow up. This pizza delivery boy, he has no idea how to rob a bank, never did nothing bad in his life. But when he had a bomb strapped to his chest, he realized, oh, you know what?
Desperate I got to do it. Desperate times come for desperate measures.
Listen, gotta this figure is what it I got to do. I'm treating the gym like I got a bomb on my chest.
Uh-oh.
You know what I'm saying? Like, it's just time to go. Like, I'm just ready to go. You know? It is what it is. And we in the NYAC. And now we in the right place.
And they're sponsored. Exactly. By the Olympics. So, he's in a good facility. Exactly. A good aspect. A good, all he has to do, again, is just participate with the program and win. You know, as he continues to strive, Mike will achieve the goals that's necessary to achieve, and that's trying to win one of these tournaments.
And now, Shawn, probably the most important question everybody out there is probably asking about Mike is, you got to tell us where this nickname Milk came from.
Oh, man.
You got to do it.
It came from Mike. The name came from Mike. You just chilling out with Milk, Milk. So after a while, it became spoiled milk, hot milk, no, chocolate milk.
That's everybody else.
Yo, no, that's me. That's me too. I mean, just messing with him because, but no matter what, it's milk. But when you look at it, milk comes in all different flavors, right?
It does.
There you go. I mean, you got skim milk, you got goat milk. You know what I mean? But it's still milk, and that's what I like about the kid. So in other words, I'm saying is that he's no matter what flavor it is, it still winds up being Mike.
No doubt.
You know, and that's what I like about him. And that's what I like about Milk.
And you know what, Mike? When you get out there in the ring, you're looking for that milk money.
Yeah, that's it. Milk money, that's it.
And we don't spill the milk.
There it is. All right, now we good now. See, we got some stuff with it now. But we know both of y'all got some things to attend to. And we'll most certainly be back out here once again at the New York Athletic Club to check you two out once again. But Mike
Milk Marshall.
Milk man.
That's Mike, it is.
Mike, you got too much entertainment on your hands to not let everybody out there know how to get at you on social media.
No milk done. Make sure you know that, baby. How you like me now?
Mike, let them know how to get at you on social media.
Yo, get at me on Twitter, Fly Mike Marshall. On Facebook, Immaculate Mike Marshall. And I keep changing my name.
You don't even know what your name is right now.
Fly Mike _the_drama_king. I'm the drama king on Instagram.
But that's about to be changed to Fly Mike Milkman.
I'm about to change it all over.
All right, now Shawn had to do the walk off, but he knows we appreciate his time. Yeah. And Mike, as always, we definitely appreciate your time as well.
Absolutely.
Keep doing your thing.
Yes,
we definitely going to be keeping up with you as well.
Yes, sir.
But from our side over here at Resolution Sports, thank you once again for the time.
The real deal, baby.
Only
mess with the real, you know?
That's a nice looking shirt.
Yeah.
Now I would have stayed, but I got a shirt. I'm just kidding.